In this video, we're going to explore how we can leverage collections to create multi-tiered filters that help our users navigate Pi Vision displays. In this example, I'm working with a room, rack, and server setup. My first level is a room. I might have one or several rooms in my facility that I'd like to keep track of. Additionally, inside each room, there's likely going to be multiple racks. So now I have different rooms, and all of them have a unique number of different racks, and on each rack, we have a number of different servers. So I would like an easy way for my users to look at a Pi Vision display, the different rooms, racks, and servers, so that way they can easily see the information that they're looking for. Going back to Pi Vision, I can see that I have a filter at the top called Room. I can scroll through, and you can see that I have a scroll bar to the right. And if I'm in DC Room 1, I'll double-click. This may take a second to update the display, because it has to go back and communicate with AF to make sure that it's pulling in all the right options. Now you can see that it's updated my rack information when I click on it. And now I'll need to select a rack. Let's select A1. And now that I've selected A1, you can see that my servers are updated as well. And I can see all the different servers that exist in the DC Room 1 on rack A01, and I have the whole complete list of servers. When I click on a server, it updates my display. Let's get started with configuring how the display is from the bottom up. To begin, I'll click on New Display. Go to my database. Here you can see my rooms, the different racks in each room, and eventually the servers. So I can just choose one of my servers and begin building my display from there. I'll start off by making the graphs that I'd like to show at the end. One for demand, and then one for the temperature of the exhaust, and the temperature of the inlet. I can resize these. I'll also want to get the value of my element name. That way, anytime this updates, I'll know which particular server I'm looking at. I'll format this to only show the server name. Next, I'm going to start creating my collections. So we can start by building out the room collection first. So if I go back up to my main level, you can see I have three rooms here. So I'm just going to click on one, and I'm going to get the room name. And similarly, I'm just going to get the value. And now I'm going to convert this to a collection. You can see on the right that there's a lot of editing that you're able to do with collections. We have another video on the channel linked in the description that goes over more general aspects of collections. I like to limit the visibility of my collection to just one room in this particular case, because that way, if someone is looking at this display, it's clear which room, rack, and server they're looking at. Next, I want to make sure that I keep everything labeled. I can just add in some text boxes. And next, I'm going to create similar collections for both the rack and server levels. So if I go down one more level, I'm going to take the rack location as the value that I'd like to create into a collection. I'll format the value, showing only the coordinates of the rack location, and I'll add some text. And lastly, I'll do my server collection. So now comes the important part, which helps make this multi-filter work, and that's going to be creating these navigation links. So what I'll need to do is right-click and do Modify the Collection. I need to select my individual attribute, right-click, and do Add a Navigation Link. For this navigation link, we'd like to change the context of the current display, because that's going to adjust how the other items on this display behave, and we want to use this current asset as the root for the rest of the display. We're going to do the same steps for the other ones as well, and that ensures that the rest of the display adheres to the root that we're selecting as we drill down through these multi-tiered filters. I just need to click here to exit the modify mode. Go back into my editing mode. And perform the same steps for the rack and server levels. It's going to be the same selections for all of these levels. So let's see our display in action. If I'm viewing PyVision as a user, I'll select my room. In this case, it's going to be room 1. I can select my rack. I'll choose A04. And then I can choose one of these servers. And just like that, my display is updated. Another example, if I wanted to choose A01 and then choose one of my servers there, the display updates and I can see all the relevant information that I need. Keep in mind, there are many different use cases where this could be helpful for. The room, rack, and server is one general use case, but you could have many different types of equipment that, if arranged in a hierarchy correctly, will help you leverage collections to produce these multi-filters. This differs from the use of using the asset dropdown and configuration menu as well. Different filters limit our possibilities that our users will have to click through at the end of the day. Again, building this display, it's highly dynamic as I can add in different servers, racks, and rooms accordingly as my operations necessitate it. And I get a lot of value because it increases my ability as a user to only have to select a few options that are relevant. I hope you enjoyed this video and are able to implement something similar in your company.